The Life of Robert E. Lee by Mrs. Mary L. Williamson. The Life of Robert E. Lee by Mary L. Williamson. The following is a poem at the beginning of the book. The Sword of Robert E. Lee. Forth from its scabbard, pure and bright, flashed the sword of Lee. Far in the front of the deadly fight, high o'er the brave, in the cause of right, its stainless sheen, like a beacon light, led us to victory. Out of its scabbard, where full long it slumbered peacefully, roused from its rest by the battle song, shielding the feeble, smiting the strong, guarding the right and avenging the wrong, gleamed the sword of Lee. Forth from its scabbard high in the air beneath Virginia's sky, and they who saw it gleaming there, and knew who bore it, knelt to swear that where that sword led, they would dare to follow and to die. Out of its scabbard, never hand waved sword from stain as free, nor purer sword led braver band, nor braver bled for a brighter land, nor brighter land had a cause as grand, nor cause a chief like Lee. Forth from its scabbard, all in vain, forth flashed the sword of Lee. 'Tis shrouded now in its sheath again, it sleeps the sleep of our noble slain, defeated, yet without a stain, proudly and peacefully. Chapter 1. Birth and Youth. Robert Edward Lee was born at Stratford, Westmoreland County, Virginia, on the 19th of January, 1807. His father, General Henry Lee, had been a great chief in Washington's army. They sometimes called him Light Horse Harry Lee. While with Washington, he was ever in front of the foe, and his troopers were what they always should be, the eyes and ears of the army. After the war, he was governor of Virginia and then a member of Congress. It was he who said in a speech made before Congress after the death of Washington that he was first in war, first in peace, and first in the hearts of his countrymen. He also said, "Virginia is my country. Her will I obey, however sad the fate to which it may subject me." The long line of Lees may be traced back to Lancelot Lee of Loudon in France, who went with William the Conqueror upon his expedition to England. And when Harold had been slain upon the bloody field of Hastings, Lancelot was given by William the Conqueror an estate in Essex. From that time, the name of Lee is ever an honorable one in the history of England. In the time of the first Charles, Richard Lee came to the New World and found a home in Virginia. He was a man of good stature, sound sense, and kind heart. From him the noble stock of Virginia Lees began. He was the great-great-grandfather of Robert, who was much like him in many ways. Robert's mother was Anne Hill Carter, who came from one of the best families of Virginia. She was a good and noble woman who lived only to train her children in the right way. Stratford, the house in which Robert was born, is a fine old mansion, built in the shape of the letter H, and stands not far from the banks of the Potomac River and near the birthplace of Washington. Upon the roof were summer houses, where the band played, while the young folks walked in the grounds below and enjoyed the cool air from the river and the sweet music of the band. He had two brothers and two sisters. His brothers were named Charles Carter and Sidney Smith, and his sisters, Anne and Mildred. When Robert was but 4 years of age, his father moved to Alexandria, a city not very far from the Stratford house, where he could send his boys to better schools. But he was not able to stay with them and bring them up to manhood. Shortly after he had moved to Alexandria, he was hurt in Baltimore by a mob of bad men, and he was never well again. When Robert was 6 years old, his father went to the West Indies for his health. While there, he wrote kind letters to his son, Charles Carter Lee, and spoke with much love of all. Once he said, "Tell me of Anne."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.